GPT-4 is out, and this time OpenAI published 98 pages of a technical report. Reading this report was actually very frustrating for reasons that will be clear soon, but fortunately you don't have to read through all of it because I compiled the key points here for you. So after having only a blog post for ChatGPT last year, we're finally getting something that feels more substantial, right? Maybe we'll get the model size, the number of parameters, the training data. Wait, none of this is actually disclosed. Early in the report, they claim that because of the competitive landscape and the safety implications, they don't report any details of the architecture, hardware, training compute, dataset construction, training method or similar. That's a bit of a shame. So most technical details are not disclosed, which is not really an open approach from a company called OpenAI. So what do we know? Well, compared to previous versions, GPT-4 can process not only text, but also images. And because it can process different types or modalities of data, we can say that GPT-4 is multimodal. Now, adding more modalities can, in theory, significantly improve performance. GPT-4 will now have access to data from charts, tables, or things like memes. Its vision capabilities will open doors for many interesting applications. For example, in their live demo, OpenAI showed that you can quickly sketch an idea for a website, give it to GPT-4, and it will produce a working prototype within minutes. This all sounds amazing, right? Well, the report barely mentions anything about the vision, actually. Pretty much all we get is this tiny section on page 9 saying that they plan to release more information later. And we also get a few cherry-pick examples. That's not great for a 98-page report. Also, while GPT-4 is already available on ChatGPT+, the image functionality is still missing there. Focusing on the more positive things, GPT-4 is better at what it was already doing, and OpenAI demonstrates that by showing an improved performance on academic and professional exams. We can see a long list covering a variety of exams like the Uniform Bar Exam, APs, and even LeetCode. The reported table compares GPT-4 with GPT-3.5, which is basically ChatGPT, and shows a big improvement for a few of the exams. The results are overall very impressive for language model, but keep in mind that these stats were designed for humans and not for chatbots. So they might not be the best for benchmarking chatbot's ability to reason and understand what it's saying. The bar exam, and exams in general, don't only test your knowledge, but also your time management, ability to stay calm under extreme pressure, and fast-paced thinking and analysis. These factors are irrelevant to machines. Fortunately, OpenAI also lists improved results on the standard research tests, comparing different language models. Since these benchmarks were designed to specifically test AI models and cover linguistically and cognitively complex tasks, I find these results more compelling. GPT-4 beats both the GPT-3.5 and the state-of-the-art systems on almost all tasks. Some results are also very close to human results. For example, the expert-level accuracy for MMLU is approximately 89.8%. GPT-4 is very close to that and beats the fine-tuned FalmPalm model from Google by a big margin. FalmPalm has 540 billion parameters, which is 3 times more than what GPT-3 has. But then again, we don't know how big GPT-4 is. The next important thing to note is that GPT-4 has larger context window. ChatGPT can process up to 4,000 tokens as its input. That translates into something like 3,000 words or 6 pages of text. That is a lot, but I found it sometimes limiting when summarizing long articles. Well, GPT-4 increases the context window to up to 32,000 tokens. However, this will be a gradual increase, and it currently supports only 8,000 tokens. The next one is about training datasets. The common phrase in machine learning is that models are only as good as the data they are trained on. As I mentioned, the paper doesn't directly tell us anything about the data. But we can make estimates from previous papers and this report. From the GPT-3 paper, we know that they use filtered web crawl data, like common crawl and web text. They also use long documents, such as books and Wikipedia articles. Next, there is GitHub. Because of OpenAI's collaboration with Microsoft, which owns GitHub, they can access quite a lot of data. For example, in the Gopher paper, DeepMind reported that their GitHub dataset has over 400 billion tokens. Now, in the appendix of the GPT-4 report, we can find out that they also added subsets of training data from GSM-8K and math datasets. This was done to improve mathematical reasoning, and it would explain the big improvement on the GSM-8K task, the SAT math exam, and other math-related tasks. And lastly, I assume they use more ranking data from human demonstrations, and more dialogue data. The information cutoff for data is supposed to be the same as in ChatGPT, September 2021. But we can find in the footnotes that the pre-training and post-training data contain a small amount of more recent data. But how big is a small amount when your entire training dataset has trillions of tokens? This kind of phrasing can hide some relevant information. Number 8 is about improved alignment and safety. Here, OpenAI made significant progress. For sensitive requests like medical advice and self-harm, GPT-4 follows OpenAI's policies 29% more often than ChatGPT. And for disallowed prompts, like asking for instructions on building a bomb, they decrease the model's tendency to respond to such prompts by 82%. These improvements were achieved by building special moderation classifiers that use the GPT-4 model itself. In this area of research, OpenAI is actually sharing a bit more, publishing the instructions for these classifiers, which you can find in the appendix of the system card. And my last note is about upcoming features and publications that OpenAI promised. I've already mentioned increasing the context window to 32,000 tokens and adding the functionality to upload images. They are also gradually rolling out API for GPT-4, currently for people on the waiting list. And in addition to new features, they also promised to soon publish some thoughts on the social and economic implications of AI systems, including some initial steps for regulation. Not sure how to feel about that. So these are my top takes from the report. Overall, I'm very excited about these advancements, but unsure about the closed source approach that OpenAI is taking. Clearly, GPT is now a product for OpenAI and they have a profitable business model. But this technology is based on lots of open research. Transformers, the underlying architecture of GPT, was introduced in 2017 by a team at Google Brain. If they didn't disclose their research due to the competitive landscape, that would significantly slow down the progress of AI, and we would probably not have ChatGPT now. This attitude can also make other companies follow suit. But anyways, let me know what you think in the comments below. Please subscribe for more content, and thanks for watching.